This is late breaking news from Eyewitness News 5.
I'm Jessica Schambach. We're following late breaking news right now. The governor has just issued a state of emergency because of the impending winter storm. And right now, there's a press conference going on about the city of Oklahoma City. Let's go to street maintenance director Mike DeGiacomo with the latest.
We did that this weekend. Today, of course, we're mounting the rest of our snow fighting fleet. We'll have about 25 trucks, about 18 snow plows, and 4 motor graders. That'll be staged and ready to go by 6 o'clock tonight. And then I have a full staff on at noon today, and they'll work till midnight. And then I have another full staff coming in at midnight, and they'll work till noon tomorrow. And we'll continue that process as the storm goes. A lot of what we do is gonna be dependent upon what kind of weather comes in. We'll be ready for whatever's there. We'll be putting out some material. If we get into a plowing operation, we can do that as well. We also have our contractors on standby to do some clearing in the downtown and med center, because in those particular cases, we're gonna have to haul the material out. We can't roll it to the side. If we do get into plowing operations, we'll be plowing to the outside curb line, and so we'll open those major cross streets, but our primary purpose is to get traveling public down the emergency snow routes, and those are the places that we're going to concentrate our efforts on. If the motoring public has to get out, we would suggest that you utilize those emergency snow routes. If your car becomes disabled or something along those lines, please try to get that vehicle out of the roadway. I've got a lot of heavy equipment, and we've got a lot of vehicles that are going to try to get from one place to another. And so to have an abandoned vehicle within the roadway is going to be a real problem for us. So that's kind of the preparations we've got going for this winter storm. And so with that, it's my pleasure to introduce the mayor for the city of Oklahoma City, Mr. Mick Cornett.
Thank you. As usual, we will hope for the best and prepare for the worst. This is apparently going to be a significant storm that I suspect is going to overwhelm our ability to deal with it. Fortunately, it appears that there'll be one round of it, and then we'll deal with it the rest of the week and then try to see and how we're going to cope. I encourage people to stay off the roads tomorrow, and you've certainly helped Mike and his crew if we don't have abandoned cars on the road. If this is as bad as a Christmas Eve storm of 2009, then we're probably going to be in a really tough situation into the weekend. Know that we will be working diligently with all of the equipment and the staff and the training that they've achieved and accumulated. These are the types of storms that are really, really tough to deal with the resources that we have available to us. Like all municipalities, we gear up, we staff, and we train for the typical. And when you have these extraordinary events, it can exceed your capacity to deal with it. And so we will rely on warmer temperatures for a lot of the snow removal. I know they're going to be out with the salt trucks, and we're going to be doing the best we can. But if everybody will stay off the roads on Tuesday, then at that point we'll be able to see just how bad it is and where we need to go from there. Questions for me or for Mike? Mike, why don't you come on back? Yeah, the Mike's crew is going to be working, as you would expect. But the bulk of city offices will be closed tomorrow, as I suspect most of government will be closed. And I would like to encourage employers to think really hard about having their employees come to work if it's not essential. We need people off the streets tomorrow. We need our crews to be able to get out there and deal with this as with unrestricted traffic as possible. What's that? City buses, Christy, I would think.
I think they're going to try to run as long as they can.
Okay. Christy's answer is that they're going to try and run as long as they can. I guess they'll just have to wait and see.
Well, Well, basically, the difference between ice and snow is that the snow will actually give you some traction. If you've ever driven in actual snow, you know that you get a little bit of that material around the roadway. We can put some salt down in with that material, and so that's a little easier to get around. Ice is a whole different story. Ice is solid, it's slick, and it's really hard to work with. We'll put some material on it, but once again, there's no traction along with it. That's absolutely correct, and those are the instances that we learned with the blizzard of that Christmas Eve, is that if we go out and plow today, it may be 2 hours later and all of that material is back on the roadway, and so we've wasted our resources. And so that's why we always get in a standby mode. We're ready, we've got all the equipment that we have available to us to go out, and then once the storm hits, we'll adjust as we need to. Do we just need a little salt? Do we need to plow? Do we need to wait on plowing? If it's a north wind, we need to plow to the south side of the street, which means we may be taking it all the way across the street. Lots of variables, and yes, blizzard and snow with wind are real difficult to work with. The question was where we stand on supplies right now. We filled both of our facilities at the end of last year, and so we've probably got about 8,500 tons of material on the ground, so we don't really anticipate a problem with this storm.
With having the supplies for the storm.
Yes, correct. Yeah.
Even with staying on the emergency storm routes, obviously we've had the folks there, but like the mayor said, I mean, even those areas, even those snow routes, tough for traffic.
Oh, absolutely, and that's what that was really a question there. Yes, travel is going to be extremely hazardous tomorrow, and so even though we may be out there and we may have some material out there, that doesn't mean that driving is going to be good, and so that's why we discourage people to be out on the roadways. We'll put material out, but just because we're working that emergency snow route doesn't mean that it's going to be clear and good to go for the motoring public.
Everybody good? I see a lot of heads nodding. All right. Thanks, everybody. Thanks for letting everybody know.